back to my channel. So I'm gonna do something a little bit different today, and I am gonna kind of sort of introduce myself, which I've done that already. I think I did that already. I think so. Right, so I'm gonna like do a little sit down video and we're gonna talk a little bit. So my name is Josh. My channel name is Josh Sherp. What my challenge is about, I give you tips on how you can grow your hair healthy and strong using mainly organic stuff, right? And mainly DIY treatment to get your hair growing and in a healthy state. And also now and then I might do a little cooking on my channel. But my channel mainly is about hair. So I did a few videos where I cook some food because my daughter requested for me to do so, which I did that. Right, so my channel is about encouraging you to have healthy, strong hair by using natural stuff, doing DIY treatment, using organic product in your hair. And so far, I am really liking my results following that routine. I am a natural for about 3 years now. I have a little bit of setback earlier on because I didn't really understand natural hair. I used to have my hair perm. But I decided, yes, I want to go natural. I couldn't bother with all those chemicals in my hair. So when I started my journey as a natural, it was a bit challenging because I didn't really know how to take care of natural hair. My home. Curly state up here. I didn't know how to really take care of it. I used to watch YouTube videos now and then, go on YouTube and, you know, browse on it and all those things. And what was my discouragement? Sometimes you see they show you, you know, you realize it's for promotion. It's not merely about really the hair care, it's just about promoting brands and promoting deals. So anyways, that's beyond the point. So when my hair reached a certain length, I decided, okay, I am going to straighten my hair. Not knowing that I should put on heat protector on my hair, not knowing that. And I did go ahead and straighten my hair. And oh boy me, it would not revert after 2 weeks with the straight state of hair. It would not revert after I rinse it out, wash it out. It would be straight still. I was like really puzzled. So I didn't understand natural hair. So I just think that having natural hair, you can almost do anything to it and nothing will happen to your hair. So I was enjoying the natural state of my hair and, you know, things like that. Then I decided, okay, I'm going to straighten my hair. I'm going to flat iron my hair, not knowing that you have to put heat protectant on the hair to keep it protected. Not knowing that. So we went ahead and I did go and straighten my hair with the flat iron. And you should have seen that room. That room was filled with smoke and I didn't even realize I was burning my hair. I didn't know, but then I said because of the tool was hot, so I'm thinking, okay, that's the way it's supposed to be smelling. I didn't know that I was burning and I was damaging my hair in the process. So I did that. Then I realized my hair would not go back to curly state. I went in, I kept it for about a week. I did not like how it looked. I kept it for more than a week. I kept it like for a month. I did not like how it looked. And I said, you know what? I take 2 days. I go in and I use the scissors and I just went in and I just cut. I just cut and I cut. And even now some of my ears is a little bit uneven. It's coming too because I keep on going to the hairdresser for them to even it up, right? Anyways, So after all that, I realized you have to take care of your natural ear. You can't just do anything to your to this type of ear. You have to really take care of your ear. You have to be careful and be mindful what you put in your ear, because you can have this nice set of ear and it all gone because of what you have used in your ear or you have treated your ear. So I've realized that. So I started paying more attention to my ear, and now I refer it. I'm using mainly natural stuff because I realized the natural, when you use the natural organic things in your ear, I realize it makes my ear looks better. It makes my ear feel better in texture. So I try to use mainly organic stuff, DIY treatment in my ear than all the chemicals. Right, so that's what my channel is mainly about. I give you tips on how I take care of my ear, and you can also follow my journey, my ear journey. So you can have healthy, strong ear also. Because my ear is, I'm telling you, I am seeing the results. I am seeing the difference just using mainly organic stuff in your ear. Less chemical, better for your ear. So that's what my channel is about. Give you tips, give you remedies on how you can take care of your ear. Keep your ear in a healthy state. If your ear is not in a healthy state, how you can get your ear into a healthy state by using organic stuff. Right? So, So I'm gonna give you the flip side now of being a new YouTuber. I tell you, it is. Someone asked me the other day, how is it going? You being a new YouTuber, how is it going? Is it easy? Is it, how is it? So, I didn't really give an answer, really. I did not. But I thought to myself, and through my experience so far, because I'm on YouTube now for a month. And when I just started YouTube, I thought, okay, all I need to do is just tell my friends and my family, okay, I'm gonna have a YouTube channel, and they will help me to grow, and they will help me to put the word out there, and voila, I would have enough subscribers, you know? But reality kicks in. Reality let me know that, okay, it don't go that way. Because the family and friends that you rely on to even watch the videos, sometimes they are not, it's not that maybe they don't want to watch the videos, but I think maybe they are too busy, so they don't really take the time out to watch the videos, and they don't understand. That's what makes the channel relevant. When they watch the videos, when they give their little comments, that's what makes the channel relevant. So right now it is really hard. And sometimes you can get discouraged, because sometimes I'll be like, I don't think I'll bother put up a video today. But guess what? I've self-motivated myself. I said that to what I see is not just a today thing. I have to look at this as a long-term career that I want to put in my, to invest into. So that's what's motivating me now. So, and then again, I like making the videos. It's a bit tedious sometimes because I work and I have a small child. So sometimes it is really hard to get the video together, but I like it. I do. So I still put the videos out, even though I'm not really seeing much views and I'm not really seeing comments, you know. But I am looking on it as a long-term investment. And I think I will stick to it because I really like making the videos. And I am not really discouraged. I'm not really discouraged. I self-motivate myself. And if you're doing something that you really like to do and you enjoy doing it, even though you're not getting the support immediately, you can look at it and just say, okay, it is not a today thing. Maybe it's a tomorrow thing. So it's just an investment. So that's why I keep myself motivated. and keep myself occupied, you know, by thinking about what video to put next and so forth. And it excites me to do that. To like, okay, what am I gonna put out next? What am I gonna put out next to get people to watch and to get subscribers? So, as I said to you before, this is not an easy thing. It is not an overnight thing, especially if you're not established already. If you're not, say, viral, or if you're not popular as a entertainer, because I noticed that even entertainers, they just put up I'm putting up a YouTube channel, and by the time they put up that channel, they have like 2,000 subscribers, 30,000 subscribers. But it is not so when you're not popular or you're not an entertainer. You have to really work for it. You have to put in the work. What I gather from it, you have to really put in the work. You have to put in the time, and you have to make sure you have videos. And I also go on other channels to listen to other YouTubers that is well established already, and listen their journey. So that kind of encourages me to continue, you know, because I was listening to this one YouTuber, and she said it took her a long time. I think her name is Kathleen Manning. Yeah, I listen to her sometime to be self-motivated, because I like listening to her. She have really good encouragement, and she says she had her channel for over a year, and before she wasn't getting much views, wasn't getting as much support as she thought she would, or whatever. I don't know if she said she thought she would, I'm not sure. But at first, she wasn't getting the amount of views and the amount of subscribers that she would want. And it took her over a year before she started to be really popular and, you know, get the amount of subscribers. And now she's like getting so many subscribers a day. So I listened to her. I think her name is Catherine Manning. I'm not sure. But she is really encouraging. So I listened to her also. So as I tell you, don't get discouraged. Don't get discouraged to start your channel. But all I'm saying to you, it is not an overnight thing. It takes time. It takes work. It takes effort to do. And you got to love it too. Because if you don't, you'll get discouraged and don't want to post no video. When you look on your video and you say you post a video today, and you think, okay, you'd get so much views. And then you look at it, you see like 2-3 views, and you have 50 subscribers, or you have 100 subscribers, and you only seeing 10 views and all those stuff. So you realize, you're not getting the support as you should. But what you can do is just self-encourage yourself, because that's what I'm doing to myself. I'm self-encouraging myself, and I'm seeing it, and I'm seeing it as a hobby for me. Hopefully one day it will become a career for me. So you just self-encourage yourself, motivate yourself, because that's what I'm doing. I'm new, I'm very new. I'm like 3 weeks on this, 3 weeks. And I am telling you, I'm just doing it for the love of just doing it right now. So right now, I don't mind if I get my subscribers. I really love subscribers. But no, all I'm looking at it like is something that I love to do. So I'm putting my effort and I'm putting my time into these videos. And all my new YouTubers, hold the faith, because I'm holding the faith. So hold the faith with me, and let's try this journey together. And I know one day we will reach the amount of subscribers that we'd love to have. But just be consistent. Just be self-motivated and just do your thing. Don't look at the numbers, because I'm not looking at the numbers right now. I'm just doing it and say, okay, I put out my video. Okay, today I put out my, because what I do, I upload videos Sundays and I upload videos on Wednesdays. So I know when it comes to Wednesday, when I get home on Wednesday evening, I have to get to it. I I get home by maybe 6 o'clock, 6:15 in the evenings. And as soon as I get home, get the kids them to get something to eat, then I said, okay, I gotta make my video. So don't watch the numbers. Just do it because you love it. You know? Put in the hard work. Go to the drawing board and see what you can do different. And what I'm doing, I am just giving you tips on what I do, what I'm doing right now to keep my channel. I listen to other YouTubers that is on the platform for a long time, and I listen to their struggles. So if you feel discouraged, just listen to one of them. You know, you will be encouraged, because that's what I'm doing. So guys, I appreciate my subscribers. I do. I appreciate the support. Just continue supporting me. I appreciate it. And just remember, new subscribers that is listening to this are people that, if you don't even subscribe us yet, new viewers that is listening to this, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe to my channel, because I have great contents and I have good tips on how to grow your hair. And right now, look at my hair. I put the oil, the DIY oil that I put in my hair. I tell you, my hair is popping. It is popping. It is. So just support me. I appreciate you. I really do. Thank you for stopping by. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.